What is up, everybody? My name is Chris, One More Game MTG. All the links are at omgmtg.com. Check Willow in the back. What's good, girl? We are playing another episode of Free For All Brawl, and on this episode, we have Galma the Shaper. It is the new Artificer-based Tempered Steel Commander. One white way for a 3-3 Elephant Artificer with Vigilance. Decent stats so far. When it attacks, conjure a card named Tempered Steel into your hand and create a 1/1 colorless mirror token. So, Tempered Steel, pretty awesome ability. It is one white artifact creatures you control get +2/+2. It's pretty cool how you can do this consistently over and over and over again. Partially wish it was an ETB effect, not an attack trigger, but either way, still pretty solid. So, now it's going to be we're going to basically play tons and tons of artifact creatures. Like, why not? Barb Spiked, Incisor Glider, Ingenious Smith for more recursion, Planar Disruption to remove things, Servo Expeditionist, Scrolls High, like you just name it over and over again. We're gonna get a bunch of artifact based creatures and try to spam the board like crazy and just go tall with this one. I think that's gonna be the best overall opportunity with this deck is to go tall and wide at the same exact time. So, you know how it is. We're gonna get several games in here, see how well this does in the format itself. Let's get right into those games and see how well Galma the Shaper shapes the format. Let's go. Okay, opening hand is not bad. They go first, turn two, and turn three potential. So we're gonna keep this. Not a bad choice. Got a little ghost dude over here. All right, we're facing the new Atraxa. Basically, you want to win before Atraxa goes down. That's the general consensus of facing this commander would be. All right, planes pass. Did not get a land. I might just do the Patchwork Automaton first. Still no land, so let's get that out there now. Has ward on it, so a little control protection for herself. Hopefully draw a land. All right, Skrull's Hive. Did not get a land, not good. So just swing it for the one. That has to be a cast ability, not an ETB effect. Hopefully they get a land. That'll basically start building up the board state overall. Alright, so it's definitely a toxic base build they're doing. I did not get another land. That's very unfortunate to see. This is a double strike, so I don't think they'll. Well, shouldn't have swung all in. That's my bad. LOL. Did not see that. Oopsie daisies. All right, Lotus Cobra comes down, starting to ramp up a little bit. All right, so we're dying fast. Still no land. Aish. All right, I'm gonna pass through no attacks. Maybe, you know. All right, Takutho. All right, resolve all. I can get rid of one. I should have done that. But they're colorless, right? Yeah, they're colorless. Alright, my turn. Jesus Christ, no land still. All give this one, make it pro black. I am going to get more poison on this attack. Only Takotha, okay. All right, block one, block this one. Take three, go down to 14, they go to 25. Still no lands. Wow. Just wow. Land. Traxa comes down. Revealed. Oh, the goodness. All right, pass. Resolve all. Do it again. Take five, go to nine. My turn. All right, wow. Good game. Nobody, lands usually help a little bit. I don't know how y'all play, but lands kind of help. All right, I was not happy. On to the next. All right, opening hand is a lot better than last time. Still only two lands this time, but I have stuff I can do it with. We are facing Helena and Elena. All right, great turn one. Rhystic Buddy is always a positive. All right, Elysian Carrieted. All right, let's do this on X1. No attacks. All right, Helena comes down. All right, we got a land, sweet. Let's get that out there. No attacks. All right, now it's gonna get a little larger. We'll make a stand. All right, they're reading it because it's a new card. All right, fight rigging. I gotta pay? They did not. Okay, draw a card. That's gonna go off very quickly, unfortunately. Why wouldn't you do? All right, no blocks. All right, let's do this. Swing in. Take one of those. All right, that's gonna make, so I can block a couple of things now. I can block with the Hangerback Walker. It'll make three threes. Ouch. Okay, they didn't get anything crazy out of it. All right, block that. I'll take several. I only make one? Oh, I thought it was, okay, I thought it was the power. That's bad. All right, end the turn. Discard two cards. I'm super dead though, so good game. Resolve all. But they even paid the three. How big you can make it, let's see. resolve all. Well, that was god awful right there. Go to the next one. See if we can win one, because these games go pretty quick, you know? Well, again, nothing. Well, three lands. We're going to go with this one because three lands. All right. We are facing Aziatora, the Fling Commander, right? Yep. All right, Overseer. This could be my chance. Okay. Would it I don't want to try that because I'd be stupid. I want to what do you call it? Play it, tap it. I don't think that would work. Chatter frame. I'm gonna still like hold full priority to see if it works. All right, my turn. One, two. X1. Yeah, it would instantly just do its thing. I don't think they'll do it. Yeah, they didn't do it. Okay. All right, that's treasures. All right, pass. My turn, okay. Got another land, cool. Scry one. Mechagodzilla, cool, keeping it. No, let's just start buffing these out. All right, swing those two in there. Here's the problem with Galma. Like, I want to swing in, but like, that's fine. I take one, resolve, brings it back. All right, boom. That's only something. Okay. I don't need to stop. All right, Angrath comes down, gain control of a thing. That's unfortunate because they're gonna get my hanger back. No, they're getting Gamma. I would have figured go after Angerback. I'll take nine. I don't want to take nine, but I'll take nine. All right, that's going away. Take the action. Resolve. All right, so do I want to get? No, let's get out the sky scanner. See if I draw a land. I drew a land, sweet. All right. Whenever you cast a spell, the amount of mana that was cast is greater than the Liberator. Put a counter on it. That's whatever. All right, Mechagodzilla. You're gonna get a counter. Out of all the things, you get a counter. Right, no attacks, end turn. All right, discard Traxos. All right, Chromatic Lantern. Pass. All right, let's skip through. All right, tap the Overseer. All right, get this out there. Because this is only one. Next. Highest mana value. All right, resolve all. And you have Death Touch on it. Okay. Swing over at, no, this goes over here. I'll pass through. Because I don't, like, I probably am doing the wrong thing by not swinging full house. That's the thing. Because it's a flank commander, you know? All right, Zeotora comes down. Is it any target? To any target, yeah, okay. I'm assuming they're gonna sacrifice Chatter. It makes the most sense. I don't know, 1-1-1, okay. All right, so I'll do a one on this, and one there, okay. One additional? Yeah. Okay, so that's a lot. I got a full swing, I think. What is this? Vigilance, okay. Let's do a full swing. This is just dumb. No, I can't do that. I'm dead either way. I feel. Wish you got lifelink. That would have been nice. I'm dead either way, so. All right, I lose 4, resolve all. So I'm super, super dead. End of turn. Good game. Wow. So if you haven't noticed, this is not a good deck. All right, everyone. So if you're considering playing this, don't. In Historic Brawl, at least. But the problem is this is only available in Historic Brawl. So it's like, yes, play it, but don't. All right, let's go to that quick recap and say why I did not like the deck. Okay, so if this commander was in paper and it just ETB'd and made that token, great. Fully okay with it. I would love this no tomorrow. But again, the problem is it's only in Alchemy on Historic Brawl because that conjure ability, it does not do well. Games I played, I said they were very aggressive towards my game itself. But the problem is there are not enough token creatures, in my opinion, that can do enough damage to the board, like to load the board state up, to start getting Gamma as a value. Because one, you gotta cast it for 3, then you need to wait a turn, swing in with it, and then attack, play another thing. So it's 6 mana to get a buff. Now, there are far more other options for buffs that are way less than 6 mana. You, with the original Artificer Elephant Dude, it was 4 and a white for a improvise the thing that brings everything together. I don't know what it is, but you were able to play it and then put a 1/1 counter on each of your creatures when they enter. So, like, it was already getting the buff itself. Getting that extra Tempered Steel effect isn't that much of a value unless you've already built the board state up. And, like, I just don't feel there's enough artifact-based creatures to, like, really get that board state up and running, especially in mono white. Overall, Dex is 0 out of 5. I did not like it at all. I just feel like there's no value in it. Would not recommend, but it's still cool to see these different effects in Commander on Historic Brawl. Let's be real here. So, thank you again for much for say that again. Thank you very much again for watching. My name is Chris. One More Game. All the links are at omgmtg.com. Remember, like, share, subscribe, hit the bell notification, whatever it may be. You know what to do. All right, y'all. Be good. Peace.